In a career spanning 2 decades, Gunda Niemann Sternemann won 3 Olympic gold medals, 19 world titles, and 98 World Cup races. She's acknowledged as one of speed skating's all-time greats. Exceptionally talented and determined though she was, Niemann Sternemann's potential was maximized through access to first-class training facilities in her native Germany, a country which remains one of the sport's powerhouses. In the former Czechoslovakia, the first speed skating association was founded over 100 years ago. But a lack of infrastructure and financial resources, especially when compared with those of its more affluent European neighbour, had precluded success on the international stage. However, earlier this year, the Czech Republic's speed skating potential was highlighted by the emergence of a new talent. Sáblíková lives in Zadar nad Zazavou, an industrial town 200 kilometres southeast of Prague. As a child, Martina played basketball before trying on her first pair of skates, aged 11. She's now one of a group of skaters trained by Petr Novák.
She started out on rollerblades and after a while I realized that she wasn't as interested in pursuing team sports anymore. She's highly competitive and loves to win all the time. Her ambitious nature convinced me that she had the potential to go on and achieve results at international level, maybe even at the Olympics.
Which runs from April to September, there are limited opportunities to train at indoor ice rinks, so technique and fitness levels are honed by daily sessions of rollerblading, cycling and running.
Rollerblading is a very important part of the training. Advances in materials used for the rollers mean it's become very similar to speed skating, and you can reach speeds of up to 50 km per hour on this track.
Standing at 1.71 and weighing in at just 55 kilos, Sáblíková lacks the powerful build of Niemann Sternemann and most of today's top skaters. But her diminutive stature belies a strength and athleticism that's also evident in her 2 wheel training sessions. Martina's biking prowess is such that she's considering competing as a road racer at the Beijing Olympics.
Já si myslím, že moje postava je na mě akorát dělaná, protože vlastně trenér samozřejmě s tím, že vlastně zná mě, zná vlastně ty lidi kolem mě, takže vlastně každý mu přizpůsobuje to, co mu bude vyhovovat a ten trénink je přizpůsobený tak, aby i já v tom, na tom těle, jak vypadám, že jsem hubená, tak abych měla sílu, takže určitě ten trénink je tomu přizpůsobený a já si myslím, že taková, jaká jsem, že je to docela výhoda.
This season, Sáblíková has followed up her Olympic breakthrough with some accomplished performances on the international circuit. She won bronze in the 3,000 metres in the Netherlands earlier this month, becoming the first Czech skater in history to win a medal at a World Cup event. Martina's success is proving inspirational to her training partners. She's also helping to galvanize support for speed skating in a country where football and ice hockey dominate the sporting landscape.
A protože nejstarší je Martina Sáblíková, 19 let, nejmladší je její bratr, 15 let, tak já věřím, že tato skupina má šanci, tak jak tady stojíme a tady jsou všichni, že budou stát v roce 2010 v Vancouveru na zimních olympijských hrách.
Takže já si myslím, že každá země je asi tak dobrá pro rychlobruslení, to záleží na tom, jaký je trenér, jaký jsou podmínky, co samozřejmě u nás díky podmínkám vlastně finančním zavře nešlo, ale taky jsou by vlastně sport invest, který nás vlastně podrží nějaký ty partneři a určitě díky těm partnerům je to lepší a lepší.